Well, he's calling it day six, and he's trying to take each one as they come. He's Corporal Willie Apiata, and he's referring to the time since his world turned upside down, when he learned he was being honoured with our highest military award, the Victoria Cross. Now, Corporal Apiata's not someone who seeks the limelight. He'd far rather be out on patrol, he told me today, when we sat down for an interview.
My mate was injured. I saw him there. So I picked him up and just carried him back to the other boys.
That simple.
And then I went back out to help my mates. But I always know and say to my mates that if any one of us got hurt or was in distress, that they'd do exactly the same thing that I did.
You have no doubt they do that for you?
No doubt at all.
When did you first know that you'd been nominated?
Sunday morning.
Come on, what goes through your head?
I can't imagine if somebody said that to you, what would go through yours?
I can't imagine how you deal with that.
I thought I was going to do that when you called me in. I was just going to do some jobs around the compound somewhere. So, you know, it was a very overwhelming experience. And I'm still taking it one day at a time.
You're giving me the impression that the honour is a shared one. You committed the act, but you say anybody else would have done it for you as well. Is that how you said, is the honour yours, or is it the SAS's?
The VC that I'm being awarded is not just for myself. It's for my mates that are here in the compound, for this unit, for all the soldiers and women and men that are serving in the wider Defence Force, for our fellow New Zealanders. This is for us.
Good four-year-old son. Does he understand what Dad's done? The magnitude of them?
I love my son and I'll be a father to him, always. But I like to keep my family and my personal life private. They're sacred to me.
Sure, I'm sure he's very proud though.
Yes.
How have whānau and friends reacted? Are you getting special treatment or are you just still good old Willie?
Hey, my family's overwhelmed, and they're very proud and, can't wait to touch base with them.
When will that be?
That's for me to know, mate.
What would you like to say to all those people whose hearts have swelled with pride at your achievements, the people who have sent the messages? You couldn't possibly answer them all individually, so.
I'd just like to say, like I said before, all the messages that I've received, everybody that's congratulating me, and this is for us, for everybody here in New Zealand. And I really appreciate all the messages that I've received. They've just supported me so much. I'd like to send you my aroha and my thanks. And kia ora to all those people out there. Thank you very much.
He is truly a gracious and humble man, and in a lovely touch. After Willie Apiata's VC was announced, the first civilian to recognise and congratulate him as he waited for a plane, the first non-military person, was none other than gold medal winning cyclist Sarah Ulmer.